I want to go one more step here because I don't want to leave some people out here. There are some who connect with this mystical, mythical, energetic being. So they then make the assumption this is never going to manifest here in physical reality. This experience means that their twin flame is in the spiritual dimensions and is never going to incarnate. And for them, that becomes a resonant frequency that they'll vibrate to. So what happens is now I'm going to give you a very simplistic spin on what is in actual fact taking place. And you can roll it around, pick through it, and then see if it makes any sense to you. I think it's obvious in our world that our society is changing, that every segment of our society is changing. When we get into the spiritual groups, the New Age groups, there seems to be this mindset that their belief system is the next reality of consciousness that's going to be here in this world. They don't like or accept the idea that their concept of spirituality may need to be made over, revised, turned over, the old ideas thrown out, one being the concept of relationship that we have now is based on, and I'll put it as simply as I can, boy meets girl, there's attraction. There is a connection. Relationship and ideas and concepts get formed, and they're not working. That is because, and I mentioned this before, basically our old format of relationships is based on hundreds, if not thousands, of years of pre-programming, pre-ideas, pre-concepts of relationships, and they don't work. They're falling apart. And we're looking for a new concept. What a lot of people are seeing in regards to these particular things, and this is where one of the reasons why twin flames, and I'm talking real twin flames here, twin flames that have earned the right to call themselves twin flames by going through the growth, the unfoldment, the melding, the molding. Initially, it can happen at a higher level. So what's taking place with these mystical experiences is a new format. This is the formulation of a new concept of a relationship that begins, first of all, in the spiritual realm, not in the physical realm, where our previous concepts of relationships have been built and have been promoted in that way, shape, and form for hundreds of years. Based on a concept that's promoted here by companies, peoples, religions, indoctrinations, and government. What I'm suggesting here is these experiences people are being blessed with, yes, blessed with, that happens at a soul or a higher self level. It begins first in spirit. It begins in the mystical dance, as it were, of a male-female connection in spirit. Then over time, it will filter down into physical reality. At some point, you will attract to yourself a relationship, a connection with another that will bring that spiritual concept together. I can see it coming. I have had this experience, and I know I'm connecting with my twin flame. The problem is, we are hanging on to those old, archaic ways. What's happening is all of these expectations that are expectations that exist here in your present state of consciousness already come into play, that get into conflict with this spiritual experience that shows you what is there for you. What you have to do is to realize, in many cases, and I'm going to be very blunt here, some people are going to have to get their head out of their ass and start realizing they're going to have to start letting go of some of these old belief systems, expectations about what you're supposed to get in a relationship and what you're going to get in a relationship, because you want that euphoric, mystical feeling, but you want it now. You don't want to do anything for it. You don't want to change anything for it. All you want to do is float away in that euphoria. And what happens is you must realize that if you're going to have that relationship that is spiritual, your concept of who you are as an individual, I am, me, mine, this, those are concepts that you have in your consciousness. They are going to get in the way. You're going to have to take a look at what your concept of a relationship was. If I could get anybody to just sit down for 5 minutes, all right, instead of running around as a twin flame couple with 15 years of experience in the exchange of energy at all levels, physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, and also I'm going to add in at an etheric body level, we do have some practical experience that is viable. And the reason that I will say that, as long as you hang on to that concept of individuality and you have the expectations based on the old mindset of how a relationship goes, I don't care if you have one of those orgasmic mystical experiences every day of your week. If you can't let go of your old concepts, when that person does vibrate toward you, you're never going to be able to get through the restrictions that you have and the restrictions that another person may have. Now, what happens is when you do come together physically, all right, that's when the connections really begin to hook up. Before, it's the euphoric, spiritual, mystical experience. The very first thing that's going to happen is probably the connection is going to create a pull. The pull is going to be dynamic. The euphoria is probably going to be awesome. And then the shit's going to hit the fan. Because you are dealing with now not a relationship of the old format, you are now dealing with a relationship of the highest order, which is a spiritual relationship, not a soulmate, a spiritual relationship of the highest order. And coincidentally, I have always found that the people who have had these experiences, if they do a little bit of history, I've always found out that prior to those visions, or sometimes around those visions, they, strangely enough, by coincidence again, have had a heart center awakening begin within them prior to the sequence of those events. People do not pay attention to any detail that happens to them. And the other thing is this, is again, and I want to reemphasize this point just so people understand this in case anybody's actually listening to what I'm saying, is we have had a massive gift. The heart center awakening is the energy of the Creator itself. At the moment your heart center awakened and you begin to emanate unconditional love, you went through a transition, you went through a change. One thing that was automatically removed from your etheric body was anything that is understood to be, from our understanding, karma. Karma cannot exist and coexist in an etheric body that has been made manifest with unconditional love. Also, what's happened is, at that particular point, new concepts and ideas and relationships can be built, and this is what is taking place at this particular point in time. And then what happens is the issues, the patterns, the belief systems. I sometimes wonder if anybody actually knows what a belief system is. A belief system is an energetic imprint contained within you as part of your consciousness that will put you in a defense mode when someone attacks it, confronts it, or you want to move beyond it and you're trying to grow. And these belief systems that you have, and they can go under culture, religion, dogma, philosophy, intellectual hogwash, education, and a whole pile of categories. You'll notice that I keep things very simple, and I don't get all airy-fairy and huffy-fluffy when I present this material to you. People are having difficulty in letting go of their individuality, of their identity of who they are. And I find it very strange in this day and age that all of the New Age people, they've all heard the word multidimensional. But then if they've heard the word multidimensional, what is multidimensional mean? It means you are a multidimensional being. A multidimensional being is not someone who has a concept of being an individual. And it's the individuality of people. I am Sharon, I am Sue, and I have my new car. My name is Dick, and I'm looking for a soulmate who we can hump and bump. This is old hat stuff. And what needs to be done is to understand that the heart center within the person, as the energy shifts and changes, what your soul and your higher self wants is for you to be happy. But you know what? I think actually people resist being happy because they're so afraid to let go of their old belief systems and their old concepts that you have to keep recreating stuff as we go along when it doesn't make any sense. And I'm going to give you an example, and I'm going to say it right on the air here. All twin flames, real ones, are going to go through this. You can take this for cash. Now, some might say, well, you guys are totally off your nut. Well, you know what? I'm in a situation now as a twin flame couple. I've now listened to what everybody else had to say, and I've listened and observed everybody else's concept of it. It goes on and on and on. And in truth, relationships are changing. That is the most important thing. The telepathic ability between twin flames, Nicole and I can vouch that it does happen between her and I. We can communicate telepathically. We don't have to put all of the emotional stuff in between it. We can communicate telepathically with the soul extensions of ourselves, and we're learning how to do that. The problem is we have a whole pile of individuals who are now connecting to this, I'm going to call it a spiritual relationship, because what's happened is this spiritual euphoric blend, a mystical union of male and female in a deja vu, a vision, whatever kind of experience you have it in, is the new awareness of what a relationship will be permanently in the physical reality. But right now, it's being set in its purest vibration at the highest level. Then you got to understand, folks, it's got to work its way down. Maybe the Creator in infinite wisdom has decided, you know, these people have really got to get their shit together before they blow this planet up. And what he decided was he was going to cause an event to happen. And what's taking place is this. The electromagnetic energy field of the Earth is going to shift. Okay, and we're going to move from, what frequency is it? Yeah, 7.5 to 12 megahertz. Okay? But here's the problem. Our concept of relationship is still functioning at 4.5 megahertz. So, if the electromagnetic energy of the Earth is shift and we're going to go from the fourth to the fifth dimension and we're going to move into a higher vibration, that our whole concept has to shift, and perhaps what's going to happen, instead of the old concept of relationship in its format, its expectations, its illogical belief systems, and the format of how you attracted a partner to yourself, you get a concept of everybody trying to live a relationship based on this old concept that society, designers, magazines, and corporate executives dictate us. And what's happening is the whole concept of relationships is switching.